And now it's time for panel discussions, and the first topic for the day is gauging the might of the market. The regional advertisers see value in broadcaster offerings and give higher ER or effective rates. The national advertisers are yet to fully understand the efficacy of the Tamil Nadu TV market and its significance. While they are now fine-tuning their advertising and increasing spends in this market, the potential for synergy is immense. So to discuss more on this subject, I now invite the first set of panelists. First, I would like to invite Ms. Mahima Singh, Head Marketing, TVS Auto Assist India Limited. Experienced professional with a demonstrated history of more than two decades working in the automobile industry. So next, I would like to invite Mr. Rajendra J Prasad, General Manager, Wavemaker. Mr. Prasad has donned many hats in a career spanning two decades of Markham experience, creative, analytics, media, and has serviced clients across various categories such as insurance, travel, petroleum, building materials, pharma, entertainment, and more in Mumbai. And next, yeah, unfortunately, Mr. L.V. Krishnan, CEO of TAM Media Research, could not make it to, as he is not well. So on behalf of him, I would like to invite Ms. Vinita Shah, TAM Media Research Vice President, to join us. Over 14 years of experience, she has been heading the marketing business development and analytics functions for TAM Access and TAM Sports. And next, I would like to invite Ms. Laya Menon, Executive Vice President, Lodestar UM. Over 20 years of experience in advertising media, choreographing, client delight through thought leadership, business development, profitability, and talent management. And I have been the key role responsibilities over the years. And next, I would like to invite Mr. Bhushan Walzade, General Manager, Brand Marketing, Paytm Travel. Can we give a huge round of applause? Come on. Yes, Mr. Walzade specializes in brand management, P&L management, sales, negotiation, team management, planning, and execution. And next, I would like to invite Mr. Akhil Jain, General Manager of Matrimony.com Limited, an evolved marketing professional with more than 10 years of experience and achievement in marketing communications, media planning and strategy, branding, annual planning and budgeting, media innovation, activations, and agency vendor management at Matrimony.com. So the session will be moderated by Mr. Mautik, Tolia, co-founder and director, Bodhitree Multimedia Private Limited. So let's give a huge round of applause and welcome Mr. Tolia on the dais. Mr. Tolia is an experienced media professional with a demonstrated history of working in entertainment media and the sports broadcast industry. Thank you.
Hello, everyone. It's an honor to host this session today as a moderator, and we'll keep this really, really freewheeling. So the idea was to have a more casual chat today, and we'll have a lot more discussions and make it a lot more interactive around here. So, you know, feel free. We'll cover our discussion points, but after that, let's just feel free and have a really interesting chat today. To just start with, I mean, a lot of big words are being used today, to describe the Tamil Nadu market, and very rightly so. I mean, from a outsider's perspective, on someone now trying to understand the market, you know, getting into it, it's been a very interesting ride. But what one cannot underestimate is the might of it all, and the bigger words like might and potency and things like that used to describe this. And you know, that is something that we can start talking about here. So, to like everyone here, what does the potency of the market really represent here? And I'm talking about not just in terms of numbers, but one when you all have been in this market and have studied this market for a very long time, what are the insights in terms of the potency of the market that you know, you feel you can put light on today? So we'll start with Mahima. What are your views, you know, from an industry point of view, from a manufacturing point of view, from the background that you come from?
Hi, I have a different perspective here to put on this table. We have seen numbers that are really good, that how Tamil Nadu market is having a lot of potential in terms of GECs. If you see now, there's a shift from the way people are watching TV. So people watch through their phone more. If you see, how is the consumer behavior? They're watching TV at home with the families. So while we talk about Tamil Nadu as a market having a lot of potential, there are 50% of people from middle age who are watching the TV in terms of that 63% of GECs that we are talking about. So that ideally should be our target audience. If I talk about targeting my area in Tamil Nadu, content is something that should be really regional. My approach should be really regional in terms of the content that we are selling. As Siju was also mentioning right now, the content, the language that we're using is to be connected in terms of what my customer is speaking. So I will not connect to a person who is not speaking in my language. So national advertisers should look at creating content which is more local, having a global approach, go local, and the content closer to the audience is coming, that's when I should spend my money on.
Okay, the expense of sounding rhetorical, I think it's important to again go back and see some numbers. Of course, yes, we saw those staggering numbers about how important Tamil Nadu as a market is for the advertiser in the country. Now, it's also important to know that, you know, Tamil Nadu is ranked number 2 in terms of GDP, and we are ranked number 6 in terms of population. And we are ranked number 7 in terms of the geographical expanse. So with just 6% of the population, we are ranked number 2. Ranked 6 in terms of population, we are ranked number 2 in terms of GDP, which makes us the second richest state in the country, which means that we have a lot of potential in terms of economy and the growth of economy. And there is no, you know, denying the fact that Tamil Nadu is an important market for both national advertisers as well as regional advertisers.
Yeah, so I think from a number-driven thing that, you know, where Rommel kind of talked about edX and the kind of volumes that we're looking at, if I just go back to 2014 and today, you've actually seen an exponential growth there. You've actually seen, you know, a growth in TN, which is possibly the second highest in this country. That's mean about an 80% FCT growth itself. That is one. Secondly, where is this growth coming from? It's, of course, due to sheer number of channels that have grown is one point, but the other interesting fact is the top 10 national advertisers are the ones which are bringing in growth. And that is where you actually relate to the number that shows about GEC. So GEC is driving the growth here, but not to be left behind are the regional players, which are actually looking at the a little cheaper possibly version of genres like movies and music. But GEC and movies are actually capturing the whole of FCT, that is, you know, about 80% of the FCT itself. So I think the market is very, very television friendly, as I would put it. And it is just going to keep growing. Of course, the screen is changing, as we are saying, and we keep talking about it. But the core market is going to concentrate on television. And I think we're just exploring where we are sitting here with digital and other kind of, you know, first screen mediums that we're talking about.
And from an agency point of view, because that's again extremely important, does the might actually translate in monetary manners, or any input that you have in terms of the clients that you deal with? What are their perspectives when it comes to the market?
So when it comes to TN, actually the proof lies in the pudding, right? You know, this is over the years. We have seen brands, I mean, more than 10, 15 years back, it used to be FMCGs used to lead the show in terms of actually creating breakthrough, innovations, and actually TN led the show. I remember Horlicks creating a particular program called Opodu, I think, which was fairly innovative in those times, and, you know, that has actually given way to the Amazons of the world talking about, you know, customer programs that now actually lead to traffic. So the proof is there.
There was this other popular program called Pepsi Ungal Choice, if you remember. That was a huge hit, even if not the amount of.
Yes. So if so the proof lies in the pudding. So there's a lot that's happening from an so what I spoke earlier was from a TV perspective. If you know remaining screen agnostic and looking at online videos as such, if you will see that you know the current content explosion that's happening around. It's actually regional content which is leading the pack. Telugu is one of the languages which is like really kind of leading that exclusion as far as content is concerned. Tamil is not very far behind. So all the excitement that we were seeing on TV over the years is actually now getting infected on, thankfully so, through the online video online video platform as well. So I think there's, and you know, the numbers that we just saw, the Bach presentation that we saw was also fairly insightful in terms of the gap that still remains. I mean, despite the market being so heavy in terms of consumption, as across demographics, across time spent, across it reflects in the ratings, etc. But still, there's a gap that remains to be fixed. So sky seems to be really the limit on as far as potency is concerned.
Okay, thanks, Bhushan. You were talking about in our earlier when we were sitting there in terms of e-commerce sites and FMCGs and the way that they perceive the Tamil Nadu market. Do you have any insights on that?
So both in terms of FMCG and e-commerce, Tamil Nadu is right there on the top in terms of state and geography to do business, primarily because it is one of the most penetrated markets for both FMCG and e-commerce, and the per capita consumption is really, really high. So if you see some of the numbers, obviously we know, we heard about it, that GDP, we are number two in India, we are around 7.8% to our pan-India contribution, second after Maharashtra. In terms of per capita consumptions, SEC, A, B, and C, we are in TN, it's 70% plus compared to a 47% pan India average. So clearly, the per person consumption is very high. And the last point being the penetration, TN is in top three in terms of internet penetration in the state compared to pan India. And the literacy rate is also pretty high. So the acceptance to internet was really fast in this state, leading to e-commerce industry really thriving in Tamil Nadu as a state. And that really helps us invest in terms of media and reaching to the consumers.
Okay. Just going back to Akhil, would you want to shed any light on that from, again, your experiences from the way that you are dealing with matrimony.com in terms of how important the Tamil Nadu market is?
So one of our popular brand from Tamil Nadu is Tamil Matrimony. I'm sure like a lot of people must have found their life matter in this group. So it's a homegrown brand. We are based out of Chennai and we understand the potential of Tamil channels very well. And in fact, last 10 years, if you see the whole Tamil Matrimony brand is built on Tamil channels. So we believe there is a huge potential with the 8 crore of population and 93% of household covered with the TV. I think with the TV, for any B2C kind of a platform like us, Tamil Matrimony, which it's a huge for us, a great platform to build Tamil Matrimony, and it's been built. And last year, if you see, we have increased our spends by 35%. That means that we are seeing a lot of growth with only help of TV, and 80% of our spends goes behind the TV. So that answers the question that we see it's a huge potential for us in terms, and it's going to keep growing. I know digital is growing, but still we think digital is giving us, TV is giving us a lot of traction.
Just to add to that, a little bit of an aside, you guys will know over here, but there was this very popular show on Sun TV, which used to be Sunday mornings, which was just Matrimony, people talking about and getting alliances, and then the ratings of that used to be really, really high at one point of time. So you're just about taking that bit, ahead. I mean, it's interesting the way that, the whole linkages happen and how interactive. Maybe you can have a show like that. Just going back to our next point, I mean, and this is a little bit of a debate over here. So you have these, there's a lot of regional brands that have grown over the past two decades using the power of television, and it's a very vibrant market. and lots of retail brands, as Siju was talking about, and you know, great examples of brand building and great case studies out here. There is a perception, and you know, some of you may agree or disagree, and you know, we can debate on that, is maybe the national advertisers, while they've been they've done their campaigns and they've been active in these markets and they're spending a lot of money, maybe they've not been as effective as they should have been. What are your views on that, Jaya? Sorry, what are your views on that?
Okay, so I'll go back 10 years back. We had a campaign, if you guys remember, Dhoni from Sonata. So that was entirely done in a Tamil in Tamil language. It was not dubbed in Tamil. It created a lot of good persona for Dhoni when he was entering into CSK as a brand. And he was accepted widely in Tamil Nadu. So this is one example that we from national advertising should take care. While you're trying to enter in a new market, you should understand the culture of the territory and create ads which will connect to my audience directly. Seeking that example.
So most of it, because that the easy way out is to just dub the content. And
easy way out, but I will not connect. I will, for the sake of watching, because I have to watch my next drama, I have to watch the ad, but I will not take the communication that ad is giving me.
So what do you think about, see, more and more national advertisers now understand that, and they're not dubbing it, but they're making the same versions,
yes,
in different languages.
Yes.
Is that an effective way of doing it?
Yeah, so let's say we know what we are doing. The question is, how should we do it and why should we do it? My intent is to connect to my audience so that my product sells. That's the direct goal. And indirectly, if I'm going to communicate in a way, if my people, let's say we have Onam, let's Kerala. In Tamil Nadu, we have Tamil New Year. So there are small days that people celebrate with a lot of zeal here. If you have content created in such celebrations days, my people will connect to me and they will remember my ads.
So what you're saying, it is not just the ad that you're creating, but it's also the strategy or the planning around,
yes,
it.
Strategy is very important. Go local. That's my strategy would be for here, because connection with the audience is very important for my target.
Okay. Prasad, from your view, you will be able to share a lot of insights on this.
Yeah. So I've been part of stages where we are building the brand code. When we are starting to build the brand code and we are creating the architecture, we seem to be unidimensional in terms of creating it in one language. Like you create all the brand codes in, say, in English or probably in Hindi, and leave the nuances of what the culture is, what the language requirement is for each of the markets. Now, when you have Tamil Nadu as your priority market, and you do not consider it when you are creating the brand code itself, how can you deliver your message to Tamil Nadu, right? So it is probably, now I can term it as being lazy, or I would term it as neglect. So either which way, the entire exercise in terms of creating those customized bespoke brand codes for each of the region is much required, and that's where we are lacking.
Vinita, do you have any numbers that you can share when it comes to effectiveness of, say, national advertisers versus regional local advertisers?
Yeah, so I just mentioned that while regional advertisers can speak the language because they are part of this regional intent that they have, and what he was also mentioning, there's another thing that brands nationally have been trying to kind of push forward is through brand integration. If they've not created TVCs or advertising per se in languages that they have, I think they've tried to overcome with pushing it via branded content and stuff like that, which is actually helping the brand a little bit. But I think somewhere the fact remains that there is a definite need for content in the creative part also to be very language based, so that's when the touch points increase with because it's not a very happy situation where you see pure programming in Tamil and then you have a dubbed ad coming in. You're actually looking at a switch off happening right away, and then we start debating, people are shying away from watching advertising. So I think we all, as planners, wherever we've been as planners, that has been our issue. And I think certain brands have been very close to it. And I, while we were having our separate discussion, I was talking about how when we were handling Coca-Cola way back,
they were the first ones who actually started thinking on that lines, you know, taking their brand that while we were there, but when we get into Tamil, let's create only ads which are in Tamil. So I think brands are looking into it, but definitely a big lesson for all brands nationally to start looking into language-based, you know, edits.
I mean, the point you're making of switch-offs is very interesting, because just a day before I was talking to someone and they were saying we get a time spent for a show for 23 minutes. And I'm like, but the show is 20 minutes. They're saying, no, they watch the ads as well.
Yes.
So, and it's just unfathomable, you know, in any other market. So, do you have any statistics on the switch-offs?
There have been ad avoidance studies that we've been, like, you know, talking about. But I think as we are going towards, you know, ad avoidance from one screen to another is what is happening. So I would say as soon as somebody, from a research perspective, we believe that screen time has got divided. So as soon as an ad plays out, the person's actually watching something on its, you know, a mobile phone or something like that. So I think I would say from a research point of view, screen time is getting shared. So somewhere ad avoidance is coming in, you know.
Okay, because of that.
Yes.
Okay. Laya, from your point of view, because you would have worked with, you know, national clients as well as the regional clients here as well, is there a different approach that you you see when they're dealing with the market? Is there a certain amount of...
Intuitively, regional brands actually know, you know, it's almost like home turf for them. So they know what they're gunning behind. Even for national advertisers, I would say gone are the days when, you know, it used to be a revelation that, you know, the fact that, you know, if you have to make a dent in the TN market, you have to appeal to the locals and, you know, the crowd is very culturally bonded. And if you have to bond with the crowd here, you got to be talking in their language. I think that is like a state, that's a fact now. I mean, if you have to make, you know, a regional connect, then you have to talk in the language. But the way how it has panned out across the years, I think that is what will have to change. It'll have to become a more, you know, TV is one thing, and especially if you have a slightly more heterogeneous mix of audiences, you know, then the task is even more different. You know, it's more complex. So if for example, if you're talking about a mass brand, unless and until you have extreme focus, or for in our parlance, if TN is not P1, you know, you will end up not investing in that market, and you will leave the job to be done, to be left to the spillovers of the world, or, you know, other media or word of mouth, etc. So two things actually. One is how the market priorities structure, you know, kind of pan out as far as how critical the market is for national advertisers. And the second thing is that if you have to make a regional connect, you need to talk in the local language, and TV is just the starting point. So I think that's important.
But when you talk about customization, I agree. But then it's just about translating, say, a national creative into regional.
Yeah.
So it's just about creating a different version. Does that have enough cultural resonance, or?
I think it goes beyond that. That is just the starting point. You know, the fact that you, so it's like hygiene. The fact that you, so if you have serious intent in the TN market, then you might as well have a creative that works and connects with the crowd, and then you got to start adding layers.
But that
actually depends upon, you know, how serious, or, you know, what is the priority, so to speak, or what is the importance that the market has for the advertiser, whether it's national or regional. Regional guys will be able to figure it out because it's home turf. You'll be able to figure it out, you know, it'll be like the back of your hand. But if you're a national advertiser, then you have to figure out what the layers should be. TV and, you know, the communication being locally connected, being absolutely hygiene.
Okay. Bhushan, from a brand perspective, how would a brand like, say, Paytm, you know, tackle something like this?
So before we go to how we communicate through advertisements, I think the most important thing is day in and day out, we use our telephone, we use different apps, we use Paytm multiple times in a day. And contacting or interacting with the consumers in English will not be fair or right in an audience for in TN. So Paytm, in the first step itself, we offer, you know, 10 languages for local languages for different consumers in India. I think that is a step number one for any company to connect with the local audience. Whether it's in TN or Andhra or Kerala or might be in East in Oriya language, I think it's very important to start the first step from there where you connect with the local audience, because what happens is now the growth is coming primarily from tier 2 and tier 3 towns. And that is where it's very critical we start connecting with them in local languages, number one. Number two, also I feel not only language, I think the face of the brand. Like in previous assignments when I worked with Colgate-Palmolive, there are some brands which are very strong in particular state like TN. Example, Colgate Active Salt was a very strong brand in TN. And not only the communication, but the face of the brand, which was that point of time, it was Kajal Agarwal, which has a really good connect with TN audience. I think that plays a very important role to really establish the core brand proposition and make consumers buy the brand.
Okay. Akhil, what are your views on this? Considering that you're a homegrown brand, but then you've gone national as well. So yes, you'd be able to have very interesting insights on this.
Yeah, so we are in a category of matchmaking. So it's really important for me to understand the local nuances and try to do something around it. Only then people will understand that this brand understands me. This brand will help us me to find my life partner. So finding a life partner, finding a matchmaking, it's a unique category, unlike your FMCG or any utility brand, because it's very personalized. It's very it's something to do with their whole the life, and there are a lot of cultural nuances are involved. So how do we deal with this? Though we are a national player, but when it comes to developing advertisement or any content around our brand, we start thinking in regional terms. Like we don't have any agency which works on pan-India basis, but we work with a regional agency who can think local and develop local. So be it finding a writers or by finding a directors or any kind of content creators, we work with local guys. And thankfully that we are based out of Chennai, where you can be south capital, you can say, where you can learn about various culture at one city. So that way we deal with it. We try to learn and we try to talk to people and understand what other nuances are important. And that is actually helping us to penetrate in a regional market in Tamil also, yes.
So you're saying that your campaigns are different for different languages? Or?
Yes. We are done that in the past. We have taken the local dance. For example, I'll say that earlier last year we had developed one ad which was around one particular ritual which is called Nalang in Tamil Nadu. So something of that sort. We don't only recreate the ad, but we actually take a local nuances and then build ad around. So different campaigns, yes.
Okay, thanks. Bhushan, can you pass the mic to her so that I don't have to be passing my mic? So just going back to the next discussion point, which is to do with how do you handle the screen agnostic consumer? So more and more, while digital is a buzzword, the fact remains that it is the television content that is actually driving the digital consumption as well. I mean, catch-up TV and YouTube is a very big thing, especially here in Tamil Nadu, because a lot of media houses have their YouTube channels and they're making a lot of revenue out of it. And but obviously, you're looking at a situation where it's beyond just television, it's second screen and it's third screen and people consuming content everywhere. So for a screen agnostic consumer, obviously the relevance of traditional pure play linear advertising, while it is there, the advertisers need to think more and figure out more and more solutions to be able to challenge and reach and influence that new consumer that is coming in. And that new consumer is just not the youth. It's not just the guy who's the affluent guy. It is your maid as well, because just to give you an example, in my house the maid comes and spends more time at my place simply because we give her free Wi-Fi, so she spends more time doing the utensils, and because then she can watch all her soaps peacefully in the afternoon on the phone because her mother-in-law doesn't let her in the evening. So you're looking at all kinds of consumers watching content on different screens. So and I think that's the next big challenge when it comes to, you know, marketeers and agencies and, you know, people like you. How do you innovate? How do you integrate your advertising and your messaging for this new age consumer?
As you rightly said, it's a ever-changing constant. Change is ever constant. So we face a lot of challenges in coming up with the strategies to deal with the regional approach. I'll like to have a mention about two case studies here about Star Vijay and Z Tamil. How are they successful in entering a territory which was not so accepting 10 years or 15 years back? It's a great case study for all of us to understand what did they do. It's a collaboration with the regional partners that you do and then execute the strategy in this particular place. Now, when I talk about from a marketeer angle, I need to understand my constant changing consumer behavior. People are watching TV. What percentage of people are watching TV? How are they watching their TV? When the ads are displayed, what are they doing? That's one point of view to look at it. The other is my target audience, the age group. How are they seeing it? How are they taking my brand proposition? For example, if I have to come up with a strategy on ads in a regional market, I should communicate first what I want to communicate in a simple format in their language. That's the easiest approach that I would take. Second is, how am I going to do this? What channels am I going to use it? I will see what my target audience is using, what time they're watching. The ad should be displayed during that time, let's say on Saturdays and Sundays. So I'll keep my frequency of ad only during that time when my people are watching it. That's the second approach that we can take, timing of the ads. Third thing is the content that I will work around in the regional specific geographies.
Prasad, your
Should
views on
this? Break the sequence? Probably we can ask Akhil.
Yeah, so on the innovation front, on digital, we haven't explored much on digital as yet. Though we do a lot of digital campaigns, but we believe that television with digital is working much better for us than only digital. We have tried that, doing only campaigns on digital, but when we, I believe there is a huge synergy between TV and digital, but since we don't see digital as a standalone medium working for us, we haven't really done a lot of innovation in terms of content or integrations and all that, yeah.
But you were talking about something where when you had television and then you had ads coming in on
yes.
your your app.
Yes.
You had a lot more interactivity happening during.
Correct. So that's what I said. So when we had when we were discussing earlier. So what I was telling there. See, our product is very online. Where in our communication, we ask them to download an app. So with us, with the two screen theory now, where people are watching TV and as well as they are there on phone. So whenever ad pops up, our ad comes on the TV, and if a person is on their phone, let's for example, if they are on Facebook, we serve them ad on the Facebook too. So the chances of people converting becomes much larger. Like not earlier days where they have to watch our ad, then find a time, and then go back to the laptop and then create a profile for them. But here what happens, whenever our ads are on TV and we are also there on digital, we see a great synergy and we see huge blip in our registration bit. But with only digital, it doesn't work.
Yeah. Bhushan?
Yeah. So I think with this digital medium growing really fast now, it's really important that we need to have a 360 campaign, and Paytm, especially a travel business, really believes in that. Not only having our TVCs on national television or regional television, but at the same time, the next big thing which is coming really big now is social media. A lot of us spend time on Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, or any other apps which are there. And it's really important that we have a localized communication, and there you can actually target a particular consumer based on his profile. And it's really important to have a regional specific communication there. For a Telugu, it has to, for the APTG, it has to be in Telugu. For TN, it has to be in Tamil. Otherwise, it will not work. I think this year we had done that transition for a campaign to get more and more consumers on a travel app. And what we could see was, just to share some numbers, in Tier 2 and Tier 3 towns in TN, we saw in Tier 3, we nearly doubled the number of consumers which we could get to use the travel app.
And in tier two, we could increase the number by 70%. And that is a really drastic big number. This overall led to 60% more consumers or business growth for us coming from tier two and tier three town, which is where our business, the growth is really there. So I think it's really critical to use both social, digital, and TV to communicate and get a target audience.
Laya, from an agency point of view, any, how do you get the...
So what happens, and all these, it's not just TN, most of the other South markets also tend to be heavy on TV consumption. So the task of, optimizing the reach, so to speak, for a particular campaign tends to start with TV, as long as, there is serious intent in the market. And what we've seen is that are on top of, an optimized kind of a campaign on TV, the digital medium, that also, when I'm talking digital, you're talking about an online video kind of a platform. It adds anywhere between 7 to 10%, depending upon what you're adding. So there's a huge potential. So that here I'm only talking about screen agnostic, the AV medium as such. And on top of that, like Bhushan was saying, then on top of that, the layers of the social media, et cetera, all this comes on. So the fact that the market is screen agnostic, the fact that right on top of TV, first of all, TV itself actually provides so much of an opportunity in terms of reaching out effectively, and the added advantage of online video also, which is fairly customized to the market from a language standpoint, that also is able to add a significant amount of measurable reach, and which is, like I said, measurable. So that's interesting.
Vinita?
So here I like to, we heard somebody who's saying only digital versus somebody who's used only TV versus a digital come TV and some solutions. I think I'll just leave one food for thought here. We did some bit of analysis on the web publishers and apps which are in Tamil for Tamil Nadu versus who are advertising on TV channels in Tamil Nadu. Sadly, I think there's an opportunity there. There were only about 2.5 to 3% advertisers which were common between these two. So I'll leave it to that. So there is a big opportunity out there. And somewhere the communication between TV and, so we're talking about synergies, but it's only 3% of those guys who are actually talking on both mediums together. And what about the rest?
Interesting.
So I thought, let the digital first brands answer this question before I could. All this comes to the last mile, right? All these years, the last mile in terms of content delivery happened through cable, and we had to consume it over television. Now the last mile could happen through internet, through optic cable, and now your content is getting delivered across screens. Like Laya said, it's becoming screen agnostic, which means that we can consume the same content just not on television but on different screens, and just not through cable but through different last mile delivery systems. So what happens here is the last mile delivery system can provide the same content delivered across different platforms as well. As a media planner, I am forced to plan for just not, say, the television channel where the content is getting delivered from, but also on OTT platforms, YouTube, because the same content is getting delivered there as well, and there is a fragmentation in terms of audience. So we are considering these days multi-screen planning, wherein we consider YouTube as another TV channel. OTT platform is another TV channel. So it's not that the plan just not has Star TV or Sun TV and Star Vijay and Zee Tamil and Colors. It just doesn't have that. It also has YouTube. It has Hotstar. It has Voot. So that's how the planning has changed depending on how the content is getting delivered. This is from an advertiser and a planning perspective. Apart from that, when you consider the content producers or the channels themselves, they're also upgrading themselves to create liquid content which can flow across television to digital platforms as well. While there is a certain format, a 30-minute or 1-hour format which is getting done for television, the same type of content is getting repurposed for digital mediums as well. So there is something which we need to adapt for that.
Okay. Thank you so much for all your perspectives. We just want to now keep the discussion open. Any questions from all of you? Let us just continue the discussion.
Good afternoon. My name is J. Krishan. I am associated with the Public Relations Society of India. It is a non-profit body for PR professionals in Chennai. My question is, two speakers, Mahima Singh and Madam Laya Menon, they were emphasizing on the regional connect. Since this program is an initiative by India Television, I don't know whether the panelists can answer, but I want a message to be carried from this summit. English channels, why they conduct the programs in Hindi, especially if you can name Times Now between 8 and 9 or other one or two channels. The anchor himself plays the role of, initiate the discussion in Hindi. Sure, question should be in English, and of course, whoever is answering can answer any language they require. Why is there any direction from any government directive for this? Why that English channel finally we find in conversing in Hindi by the anchor himself?
I mean, I think the suggestion is interesting, but I think the forum is not the right one.
No, but yeah. I find it is initiative by Indian Television. Hope the summit can carry this message to the concerned authorities.
No, I think it is very pertinent. I think Anil can really, I don't think he's around, but I think we should have a separate chat with him about this. And he's okay. The one who can really take it ahead.
And the second question is, see, when you all talk about regional connect, some of the especially the social schemes, especially in southern states, in Tamil Nadu and all, they say Swachh Bharat. Maybe the urban people can understand. If it is in Tamil, if we say Thumai India, means the people can connect easily. I think there are some other faulty communication system. They should connect, and it can carry Swachh Bharat, and at the same time, it should be Thumai India. So many schemes of central schemes. I think the rural people cannot understand. That is my humble opinion.
Yeah. Okay. Thank you so much for your views. Any other questions?
Yes, sir.
Yeah.
Okay. In fact, my voice is quite good.
I think you're fine.
Good morning. I'm Jawaharlal Shanmugam. I'm basically a management professional, creative director, social activist, anti-corruption crusader, and a public interest litigant. In fact, the last 3 years taken over the first two. In fact, today I've become all the more prominent as a litigant and a social activist thanks to the TV and the print media. They have been covering my cases. I think Mahima was hitting the nail quite hard, which is very pertinent, that you need to have a connect only with the language here. Please do understand that Tamil Nadu is very unique in this country. There is something known as a Tamil pride. A Tamil culture where people have pride in that culture since times immemorial. The time you connect your product with a culture, you will taste success. Let it be even selling a Mercedes-Benz car, because I am also a marketer. I started my corporate career with a world number one healthcare company, Johnson & Johnson, and I grew with that. So if you're talking about selling a Mercedes-Benz with somebody wearing a vesti, probably RMKV or a polymer, they also have their branding through that. You need to touch that. Take even politics. The entire country was in a wave of some other thing, whereas Tamil Nadu was in a different thing. So the Tamil pride is always there. I distinctly remember Airtel ad 4G where they showed that Etimadai forest, where a bullock cart goes inside. That was something fabulous. They touched every Tamil through that ad. So the more you touch on the Tamil pride, the advertisers will have success. They will taste success. Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Yeah.
Okay, thank you so much for everyone for listening and making it such a fruitful discussion. Thank you to all my panelists. Thank you so much.
That was quite an impressive session. Thank you so much, panelists and Mr. Tolia. And I request all the panelists to stay back for a while. And now I request Mr. Shiju Prabhakaran, EVP, Cluster Head of South Business, Zee Entertainment and Enterprises Limited, and Mr. Anup Chandrasekaran, Business Head of Colors Tamil, to come on to the dais and felicitate the speakers.
so much all the panelists and Mr. Tolia for such a stimulating discussion. I request Mr. Shiju and Mr. Anup to stay back on the dais. I also request Ms. Mahima from TVS, Mr. Rajendra from Wavemaker, Ms. Laya from Lodestar UM, Mr. Bhushan from Paytm Travel and Mr. Akhil from matrimony.com to stay back on the stage. I would now request Mr. Shiju and Mr. Anup to felicitate these top Tamil TV brands and agencies who have been championing the use of Tamil television. Ms. Mahima from TVS. Okay, Ms. Laya from Lodestar UM. Mr. Rajendra from Wavemaker. Mr. Bhushan from Paytm Travel. Ms. Mahima from TVS is getting felicitated. Thank you so much, all of you. Thank you so much, Mr. Shibu Chiju and Mr. Anup.